Welcome to the July 2022 edition of oneAPI Dev News. This month, we'll be covering a fair amount of ground, so I want to remind you that you'll be able to dig into these topics by following the links in the description. Our first topic provides some best practices to keep the CPU and GPU working at the same time in the article, Efficient Heterogeneous Parallel Programming Using OpenMP. In some cases, offloading computations to an accelerator like a GPU means that the host CPU sits idle until the offloaded computations are finished. However, using the CPU and GPU resources simultaneously can improve the performance of an application. In OpenMP programs that take advantage of heterogeneous parallelism, the master clause can be used to exploit simultaneous CPU and GPU execution. In this article, you'll learn how to do CPU and GPU asynchronous calculation using OpenMP. Read the article and follow it up by checking out some of the additional resources linked on the page. Moving on, this next how-to article, Vectorization in LLVM and GCC for Intel CPUs and GPUs, presents the recent evolution of SIMD vectorization technology in the LLVM and GCC compilers for underlying Intel CPU and Intel GPU ICEs. Additionally, the article provides information about several vectorization features. It also goes over some of the performance tuning and optimizations that are continuously being developed. Next up is a brief introduction to the Level 0 API. The Level 0 API is intended mainly for library and framework developers. The Level 0 API provides more fine-grained, explicit control over device discovery, memory management, kernel submission, and inter-process communication, to name a few. In this article, you'll get a basic example to become familiar with Level 0 programming. The OpenMP offload example also provides some insights into the set of calls generated in the backend that provides a direct-to-metal inference to the offload accelerator device. Read the article and take a look at the oneAPI Level 0 specification, which contains complete API details. And finally, dig into the article, Speeding Up the Databricks Runtime for Machine Learning. The Intel-optimized versions of scikit-learn and TensorFlow deliver significant improvements in training and inference performance on Intel XPUs. This article demonstrates that replacing the stock scikit-learn and TensorFlow included in Databricks Runtime for Machine Learning with the optimized versions can improve performance and can reduce costs for customers. Read the article, follow the resource links, and get up and running with the Intel Optimized Artificial Intelligence in the Cloud. That's all for this episode. Remember to like this video, leave us some comments, and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel for the latest oneAPI Dev News. See you next month.